Cancer, this is your spiritual guidance reading for the month of November. I'm zooming in so you can see the cards. Okay. So your overall card here, our main major arcana card, is the moon. The moon card shows up because I feel like this is a time to cut through fear and illusion. Okay. And that's what's happening here, to reveal the good things about life. Okay, but you have to take the risk. You have to be able to move through this and make the changes you need to get there. Okay, even though you are confused or fearful, it's like walking through a dark room. You may not see anything. Or be a little frightened because you can't see anything, but there is goodness coming out at the end, okay? So you have surrender resentments, hold on to resentments. Holding on to resentments only poison you. Try to forgive others for their shortcomings and keep moving forward toward positive situations in your life. Beautiful. And that goes with the surrender and release card over here, okay? So that's about letting go of old thoughts, old habits, old ways of doing things, old people, okay? Don't hate them. Don't feel like they're no good for you. Don't have a very negative tone when dealing with these people, okay? Just forgive people, you know, for what it is. Everybody's on their own path. You may be a lot further on your path than they are. It doesn't make you any better than they are. You know what I mean? You were once on that particular path as well. So it's just about letting go of that or thinking that someone is bad because of that and being able to move forward from that. You also have happiness. I am aware that being happy means that I am on the right path. That's very true, okay? So whatever you do, make sure that you are going towards happiness. Don't go back to people that have hurt you because you think it's gonna be better. That's not going towards happiness. That's not being happy, you know? This is about yourself. And the reason why I say that is because you have the Eight of Water here. The Eight of Water says a desire to move on, the search for something more meaningful, spiritual and emotional growth, okay? So that's about moving on to more things. And that's what I feel like you want to do. But you can't do that if you're holding on to old feelings and old resentments, which is why you have surrender release and surrender resentments here, both of those cards, okay? The Star card comes because there is healing for you or some sort of renewal. This is also a card of gifts from the universe as well. That's what I feel with this card, because it gives you hope and a chance to heal, okay? You also have the Hermit card. This tells me that you might have to spend a lot of time alone to make the best decisions for you or that you feel like you need to make, okay? So it's like analyzing a situation, how a particular situation or people serve you, and what it is that you want to do after that, okay? You had three cards come out at the same time. You have the King of Cups, the Ace of Pentacles, and the Two of Cups, okay? So this is all about having emotional balance or balance within your emotions, okay? When it comes to taking certain opportunities that are tangible or on the physical plane here, things that you can hold, things that you can achieve, okay? And this will be in sync with yourself, okay? So you'll be able to find these things that are in sync with yourself as long as you have control over your emotions and are being very balanced and generous with your emotions. I know that sounds really weird. I'm trying to find the best way to put it, but you'll be able to achieve these manifestations or grab these opportunities if your emotions are balanced, okay? Which means that you can be able to give love or emotion within a situation, okay? You don't want to give too much emotion where it's not healthy and it seems like you're being manipulated or you are manipulating, but to keep it more balanced and to not be so angry or let love direct you, you know, like it's really hard to explain. Not being directed by your emotions as much as your mind. Okay, that's a better way to explain it. Thank you, Spirit. Yeah. And this way you can achieve those opportunities and be in sync with your particular path, okay? So your overall oracle card is Treasure Island. Okay, it came up in the upright, and this is the law of attraction, bringing dreams into fruition. The results of positive thinking may manifest, abundance appearing as if from nowhere, financial gains, and the sharing of good fortune. Okay. You've worked hard and acted upon your unwavering belief in abundance, and suddenly in the midst of it all, you hit the jackpot. You have uncovered the map to bury treasure and trap the unlimited potential within you. What you must hone now is your ability to recognize when X marks the spot, because some of these golden opportunities may be obvious, but others may not be readily apparent. Trust your intuition to light your way now as you enter your truly prosperous phase, where all the long hard work navigating your inner life is now paying off externally. Beautiful. That was a good way to explain those cards. Trust your intuition to light your way now as you enter this truly prosperous phase where all the long hard work navigating your inner life is now paying off externally. In all aspects of your life at this time, you'll have good fortune. Don't forget to enjoy it and share it with others as treasure share multiplies like magic. Thank you, Spirit, for your guidance. So, Cancer, I hope that resonated with you in a way that you can achieve your messages from Spirit. Thank you for listening. I love you very much. I'll see you next month. Love and